The Swing by Jean-Honoré Fragonard is one of my favorite Rococo paintings because of its sly flirtatiousness. This is clearly a scene of game playing, a young woman swinging in a verdant garden. But as we look closer, we realize that this children's game isn't quite so childlike. Let's start with what the maiden is doing on that swing. You might have noticed that she appears to have lost her shoe, as you see that slipper lifting off and away from her foot. But do you think this was an accident? As she lifts her leg, her skirt opens to expose her stockinged legs and undergarments. If you look at the lower left of the composition, you'll see a young man reclining or maybe fallen into the shrubbery. He appears to be innocent enough until you notice where he is looking, right up the skirt of the swinging maiden. Now, there is so much fabric there that the gentleman is only seeing layers of silk. But it still would have been quite scandalous and titillating for a lady to display an ankle or an undergarment in this way. We now realize that the lady isn't just swinging, she's aggressively flirting, playing the age-old game of love, and her gentleman friend is a willing accomplice. She pretends to have lost her shoe, and the gentleman pretends to have stumbled in the garden, but it's all an act. The real game here is lovemaking. Fragonard adds some details to the artwork to heighten the stakes of the game being played by the two young lovers. First, look at the sculptures in the garden. Here we see two putti gazing appreciatively at the young couple's game. And what is this sculpture doing on the left? This putti has his fingers to his lips, as if to assure the couple that their secret is safe with him. For after all, this is a place of love. Did you notice the gentleman in the background, who was noticeably older than the couple? While he pulls the woman to and fro, he's in the shadows, able only to vicariously participate in the amorous contests before him. His aged presence sharpens the couple's youthfulness, giving even more potency to their flirtatious encounter. Finally, notice the abandoned rake and broom at the very bottom of the painting. Fragonard is telling us that work has no place in this paradise of playful love. To finish our analysis, see how Fragonard has enclosed the couple in the garden. This is a bower, a kind of space enclosed by vegetation. The trees and shrubbery sweep up the right side of the composition and arch over the maiden, providing the perfect shelter from the prying eyes of adults. Fragonard paints a riot of leaves and branches as if the vegetation is shaking with glee to see the couple enjoying themselves so. The greenery is painted with bright greens and yellows, shadows added to give just the right sense of depth and privacy without becoming oppressive. The woman's pastel pink dress stands out against the pale blues and greens of the garden and asserts her presence and actions.